sweat and my rust. I'm breathing in the chemicals. I'm breaking in, shaping up, then checking out on the prison bus. This is it, the apocalypse. Whoa, I'm waking up. I feel it in my bones, enough to make my system blow. Welcome to the new age, to the new age, welcome to the new
Got one. Yeah. All right, guys, fish number one, chatterbait. Little guy. He absolutely creamed it, too. That was cool. All right, guys, so what I'm doing with this Senko, or yum dinger, you know, soft plastic stick bait, is I'm throwing it out there as a nice milfoil flat, nice grass bed here. And what I'm doing, I'm just letting it, like, sit, and as soon as it takes the top of the grass, pop it. Then I just keep on repeating. And this is, you know, the deal with the, you know, the soft stick bait, oh, it's a do-nothing bait. You know, you're going to catch fish that way, but I feel, you know, not all the time that's the way to go. Sometimes it is, but not all the time. And, you know, you can get a lot more fish out of it if you, you know, you're more versatile with how to fish this bait, because it can be very versatile. Now, yeah, you can Texas rig it and put a weight out and drag it through, but I'm talking about weightless Senko. Everybody says, oh, just, you know, throw it into a hole and just do nothing with it. Like, no, you can power fish it. I mean, you're still finesse fishing, but you can cover a lot more water than, you know, you're supposed to. I see fish breaking. What's gonna happen next? I wonder. I think we're about to get a fish on top line. That's what I think. That would be cool. Alright, let's see. Let's see what happens. Walking popper. Got one. Dad. Popper. Alright, guys. Well, first cast of the top water. I tried it earlier and it wasn't working. Nice little fish in the top water. How about that? That's awesome. As soon as it hit the water, too, he swirled on it and grabbed it. That's awesome. Always follow up on top water with a Senko. It might be too long, but threw the Senko out, put it down. He hit my topwater, it was just sitting there. How about that, man? Can't beat that. It's a gorgeous spring day, catching them on topwater. It doesn't get much better than this. Man, he ate that thing. Holy crap. Look at that little guy. How about that? Topwater. They're hitting it good today, guys. You know, you notice, you know, always be observant. You know, you see fish hitting bait on the surface. You know, that tells you something. That tells you that it is time for topwater. And you know, there's over a submerged grass bed, and you really don't want to throw a pop. You know, you can break the frog out once it really starts getting matted up, but it's submergent, and you can't beat a popper. You really can't. Got one. There's number seven, guys. Got one. All right, guys, fish number eight. I swear they're getting smaller and smaller. Unbelievable. Got another one. Guys, there he is, number nine. Got one, big one. Oh my god, that's a giant. Oh! That's a big fish, boys. Oh my goodness. Yeah! There we go. That is a toad. God damn, man. Look at the way he ate that chatterbait. Oh my god. Guys, here's what's going on right now. There's a nice grass there. There's some milfoil grass. I took my chatterbait and threw it along the edge. And this slunch puppy devoured that chatterbait. Look at that thing, man. Sweet. Got one. Ooh, that's a good one, too. Oh, get out of that grass. Oh my goodness. There we go, that's a good fish. There we go. right in the corner of the mouth too. Look at that. Ooh, easy there, buddy. That's my 11th bass of the day. I give it a pound and 3/4. There we go, that's a nice fish. That was a good fish. I felt like I had 2,000 pounds of grass on. That was so much fun. I just threw it like, see where it like forms a point, the grass? You see that? It formed a point, and I threw it right in there, and it went thunk. Made a big thunk. That is keeper number two, or keeper number five, fish number 12. Dude, I was reeling in those reeds. Oh my goodness, man, he crushed that thing. Alright guys, there it is, keeper number 5. Alright guys, so I need to check this out. This is it's the pre-spawn. It's not hard to figure that out based on the way we've been catching them and all that. But look at this spot. So, you know, fish will set up in areas near spawning grounds, and this point extends all the way out. And fish will stage on the end of this point, and they will wait to move up. Now, spawning area. I have spawning areas all around me. Some of these fish could be staging on these points right now. Kind of a shallow point, but I'm not walking out right now. I got boots on. But I'll definitely relate to this. Some way, shape, form. The wind's blowing right into it too, so this could be a good spot. Oh, look at this fish. That was insane. What a fight. That thing tried to beach itself. Good God. That's a good fish, too. There we go. There's number 12, guys. Good one. Wow. Look at this wind blow, guys. This is insane. You got a storm of brewing. Oh yeah. We all know bass love to feed in this type of weather. Especially those good old greenfish. Got one. Oh, that's a good one too. Look at this fish. Oh, that's a good fish. Oh boy. There we go. Thought I was snagged on a piece of grass or something. No. for that fish. Look at that solid little chunky bass. Prespawn. Look at that. Hey, I thought I was hung up, but nah. Nice little largemouth. Seven keeper. Look at these awesome solar bat sunglasses. I can see under the water with ease. Even better when it was sunny out. I also have my Aaron Martin Signature Series solar bat sunglasses in the truck. I left it there. But that's better for cloudy conditions, you know. It was sunny to start the day, and that's why I fish with these. And I didn't have a lot of space in my bag to pack them. But on cloudier days like this, you really want to be wearing amber colored sunglasses. And I'll tell you what, guys, solar bat makes some phenomenal, phenomenal stuff. They are amazing. They make awesome prescription lenses, awesome just regular polarized sunglasses, non-polarized sunglasses, and use promo code in all caps, JEFFS, that's J-E-F-F-S, to receive 20% off of your purchase. And that is a purchase you will have wished you had made years and years ago. They have allowed me to fish to the top of my game. They're truly, it's funny too, because I've never fished a day in my life without solar bats on my head. It really says something. I just never had seen a need to change brands. Is that good? Slow down a little bit. I'm going to go back to my Senko. I feel as if that is what I need to do. Seems like I'm only like getting like a fish or two in an area on a chatterbait, on a moving lure, and then I'm just kind of having to slow down and dissect it more, and I got a couple more on a Senko. Oh boy, that's giant. That's a good fish. Oh my goodness, that's a good one. What is this? Solid fish, 2-pounder at least. All right.